Well, I hope you're having as much fun as I am with this, and maybe I've whetted your appetite. I wanted to just give you in this segment insider secrets. Well, one thing you may not be aware of, and because of the way that you approach real estate sales, because of how you've been taught, right? They say, well, the new buyer coming in, they're going to go get a new loan. And that's going to pay off any existing financing on the property. And the seller is going to get the difference between the existing financing and whatever we sell it for, minus all of our expenses, right? All the cost to sell. So the seller is going to get that amount. And they're going to go buy another property or whatever they're going to do, right? Well, that's not at all our world. So an insider secret for a real estate investor is that I go in with the plan that I am not going to go to the bank. I am not going to qualify for a loan. I've been in this business for over 40 years. I'm proud to say I never have. I've never purchased a single property by going to banks and qualifying for loans on a single family or small multifamily property. Very proud of that, because the fact is the seller can be the bank. Now, that's probably been X'd out of any kind of thought pattern that your broker or any kind of real estate training that you've had in the past. They've always said, nope, the loan, and they don't even have it in your contract that the seller can carry financing. Now, you are aware, of course, that they can carry financing, but they keep it a really hidden secret. And there's a reason for that. The broker feels that there might be some kind of contingent liability for them even participating in a transaction where the seller does carry back financing, and God forbid it goes bad and now they're going to sue the agent and the broker and all this sort of thing. It's kind of a far-fetched concept, and maybe that's happened in the past, but it's very unlikely that that would occur. However, it is a potential liability. So they just say, nope. Don't talk about that. Well, what if you come in, you make your presentation to the seller, the seller has equity, and it can be a significant equity, and they don't need it right now. They already have their new house built, they're downsizing, they've already got another place, they've already got financing for it, whatever the case may be, they don't need all of that money, or maybe they only need some of that money. And so what can happen is they can carry back financing, purchase money financing. It's the best thing in the world. And it's how I've funded many of my deals. Now, the second way that we're creative is we're able to come in and take over existing financing on the property. We take over the existing payments. This is not the course to explain all that, but I just want you to be aware that there are other ways that are insider secrets that real estate investors have that real estate agents either don't know about, never trained in, or were told not to do it. But I assure you that the things that I'm sharing with you are perfectly legal, and that it does make sense for many sellers to actually be the bank. One of the things that we provide to many of our sellers is a steady income stream on a monthly basis. Well, some people know that if they got a hunk of money, that hunk of money might disappear. They also know that their family is predators and they might come in and take some or all of that money for themselves. And they are not strong enough in their relationship and powerful enough in their relationship with their family members that they could actually lose that money. So when we propose to them that we can pay them $300, $400, $1,000 a month and steady income stream instead of them getting a lump sum, they actually like it. They prefer it. They want it. So that's another way that insider secrets come in to help us to increase our return. And, you know, another secret that I'll throw in here is there's ROI. You've probably heard of it. It's called return on investment, right? Return on investment. And that generally means that you purchase a property for this month, much. And when you rent it out monthly, you're receiving an income off of that. And that income should be more than the amount that you paid for the property, plus any repairs that you did to it, plus any costs that you have, such as property taxes and insurance. Well, that differential is your return on investment. Now, in our world, because of the additional profit centers that I was teaching you earlier, and we've got 25 of them, we take that and now supersize that with additional income that are insider secrets for our business model. And the other side of that is that once you've got the opportunity in front of you, purchasing that property for less than market value because of the cost to sell and because of the financing that can be provided by the seller. Well, you just saved closing costs, you just saved origination fees, you just saved other costs as well. So it's amazing just how great the return on investment can be. Now, the other secret I'll throw in here is return on energy. So think about the amount of energy you spend as an agent to find, let's say that you have a buyer and you have to now go find a property that they like. And now you have to take them out and you have to show them anywhere from three to who knows how many properties, right? And sometimes it gets nightmarish because people can't make any decisions. So they just get, well, I want to look at that. And I want to look at that one again. And I want to, But anyway, you can certainly expect that they're going to go back to the one that they like two and three times. So by the time you're done, the energy you've expended for what? Let's just review what? Let's see. So the commission was 6%, but that gets split with another agent. So it's really 3%, but that gets split with the house. So maybe you make on a $100,000 sale, you maybe end up taking home $1,500, which, by the way, out of that $1,500, you had to pay all your fees and all of your desk fee and everything else that it costs to be an agent. So by the time you're done, you say, man, I got to do volume to make any money at this business. My gross looks fantastic, but my net don't look so great. And that's why I kind of chuckle when people talk about being in the million dollar club. Well, that's just the price that they sold the home for. That has nothing to do with income. I want to be in the $1 million club that is take home pay, right? You want to be in the other $1 million club, which is the net $1 million club instead of the gross $1 million club, right? So I hope you're not offended by anything I'm saying here. I love real estate agents. We work with them all the time. I've had amazing relationships over decades with agents. They bring us deals. They bring us buyers. They bring us all kinds of people. I beg them to come to my trainings. I beg them. I say, listen, you're leaving so much money on the table. Thank you for the lead, first of all. Thank you very much. And why don't you come to one of my classes? Because I really will teach you how you can keep these deals and you can make money. You know, once you get to a certain place in life where you don't need money anymore, it becomes a give back. And you just want to serve people and help people to see what you've seen and to get the benefits that you've been able to enjoy as discovering these insider secrets. So I hope these insider secrets have been a benefit for you.